Now think about this. If you're an investor, a first-time home buyer, or somebody that's just been thinking about upgrading, and you've been delaying over the last 3 years, just 3 years, and 3 years flies by, you are now paying approximately 33% more for that same home 3 years later. I'm going to go out on a limb and say at a minimum, a 10 to 12% increase year over year. So if we take January of 2021 and look at January of 2022, you'll see an average, my guess is about 1% per month increase throughout the entire year. So if you own a $1 million home this time next year, it's going to be worth 1.12 to 1.15, up to 15%. And it might even be more for certain categories in certain areas. Like I think Milton as an example, I think the demand is going to be just ginormous in 2021. And I think it'll be big for anything under $1 million. Like if you own a home that's valued under $1 million right now in Milton, you will be laughing 12 months from now. And if you're in the market to buy one of those homes, better get in now. Do you think I'm accurate? Do you think differently?
No, I've been agreeing the whole time. I think you might be light on your 10 to 12%.
12 to 15.
12 to 15. Sorry, I thought you said 10 to 12.
I did initially, but then I thought, okay, yeah, as high as 15. So I'm 12 to 15.
So that's more in line with my thoughts. Yeah, I think we'll be around that. I can say 13 to 16% just to be a little bit different, but you're going to be in that range.
There were some markets that saw well over 20% gains year over year. Now think about this. If you're an investor, a first-time home buyer, or somebody that's just been thinking about upgrading and you've been delaying doing that over the last 3 years, just 3 years, and 3 years flies by real quick. If you've delayed, you are now paying approximately 40% more, call it a third, 33% more for that same home 3 years later.
Oh, and this is why I can't stress enough. You got people sitting on the back burner saying, oh, no, I'm going to save a little bit more money. Listen, you cannot save as fast as the homes are appreciating. So your money is losing value by the day.
There's a bunch of people. I don't know what they're smoking, but they keep waiting for the market to crash or they keep waiting for the market to retract. And yeah, there's going to be peaks and valleys. Like we saw in 2017, there was that huge peak and then we had a valley. So the prices retracted. But if you look at the bottom of 2017, we did the math back in 2018. If I remember correctly, it only took, let's say, 14 months and it had already met and then surpassed that value. I wish some of my stocks would rebound within 14 months and then give me the same kind of return that the real estate market has provided since then. Doesn't happen too often.
Well, and the bottom of 2017 was still kind of on par with the previous year.
Yeah, well, that's the funny thing. The bottom of 2017 was slightly below the peak of 2016. So year over year, people really didn't lose anything. So if you bought in 2016, you were still okay and were ahead of the game in 2018 already. And now, between 2018 and 2020, you've appreciated probably 25%.